So Zenkit Projects is now a reality. They released last week and it adds an addition to the Zenkit lineup. They have a suite of applications. In today's video, we're going to give you a review of the project management application, overviewing some of the features, pricing, and details about all you need to know inside of Zenkit Projects. Before we begin, do check out our Skillshare link below. You can get all of our classes and 30 days free of Skillshare with using the link below if you want to check out our productivity classes. So Zenkit Projects is now a reality and it joins the lineup of a few sweet tools. As you can see, Projects To Do, Hypernotes, ZenChat and Base, ZenChat being a Slack competitor, To Do being the Wunderlist sort of competitor, Hypernotes as well, allowing you to take really powerful notes and connect them together. But this new Zenkit Projects aims to be the project management solution for successful teams. Now it's released and it is one that a lot of people quite like having under the same suite. If you're already using To Do or another sort of experience, this could be a good option. And it touts some great global views and reports as well. Now, as we all normally do, let's start with the pricing. Now, as you can see, let's convert this over to dollars. And as you can see, they have a free plan, but they also have a plus plan, which is priced at $9 per month per user, which is fairly on price with the standard project management applications in the space. This one is much more new, obviously, so obviously doesn't have a long-term reputation in the space. However, it does have a good record being is part of a suite so far. Now, there are some limitations to these plans. As you can see, you've got a personal and plus plan, and you can see that the difference between the tasks and projects is quite vast. So if you're looking to use, you know, for example, project management with Zenkit Projects, then a plus plan is probably more suitable for not worrying about hitting 1,000 tasks. However, if you're using it on your own to plan out projects, organize your own Gantt chart, you know, be able to organize things through the Kanban boards and things like that, then the personal plan is suitable. But with the plus plan, you do get a better improvement in terms of additional features like Gantt chart and some early access features, as well as improved access to the amount you get in tasks, projects and folders. They do have a business plan, which is priced at $25 per month, which is more aggressive, giving you unlimited, almost unlimited, 800,000 tasks and 800 projects and 50 gigabytes of file storage. Whereas with the other ones, you get 6 gig and 1 gig. So this isn't really necessarily the place you'd be storing files, but if you're in a bigger team, then you'd have more accessibility to transfer things over. Okay, so in terms of features, as I said, their real sort of big ones are advanced reports and a global Kanban, and they do have a fair different range of views. In particular, we'll come to it in a moment and show you it. They've got a team wiki ability, which allows you to convert, for example, a Kanban into a team wiki quite easily. They do have Gantt chart, global calendar, team tasks as well, and obviously a to-do list, but this is all sort of varied depending on the plan you go with. So let's go inside of what we have in Zenkit Projects. Okay, so here we are in Zenkit Projects, and then you can see straight away it's very similar to most of the other Zenkit applications that you already have if you are using one. For example, this is pretty much what Zenkit To Do looks like in sort of very old school looking fashion, but one that works pretty well. So for example, what you can do is you can have a range of different views. You can go with My Day, for example, and start dumping projects there if you want to. You can go to My Week view, and what it will do is it will filter out the task based on the due date, and you can see the ones that are assigned to you here as well. Now, if I were to go ahead and create a new project, you can see that obviously it pops open, and I actually chose one of these views, but you can choose from a range of views. So for example, you can go with List view, which is very simply a list of all of your tasks, a Kanban view for creating different stages or columns and being able to add tasks below them. You've also got calendar view, which might be particularly helpful for organizing what you have in different sections. You know, for example, if I wanted to put, okay, it's Monday, I'm a little bit far ahead, but let's go to calendar. So today, there we go. So if I want to add something like recording, you can see that now appear. And as you can see, if you've already sort of experienced Zenkit To Do, you get the notes to outline, you get reminders, repeating, assigned to, tags and subtasks as well. And you can obviously in team member side of stuff, be able to go to comments and activities. But with this experience, obviously you get the ability to add dependencies and milestones, which is something that is particularly helpful. when you're trying to work in teams, and especially when you go to the Gantt chart. Because a Gantt chart view, obviously, if I were to zoom in, so obviously you can be able to extend them, and naturally the dependencies become in particularly helpful when you're organizing a project, and this is really well demonstrated on the video that they created. So you can also change the view as well. The Gantt, as I said there, is part of the plus plan. I'm not sure why it's showing it on the R plan currently. Maybe I'm on some sort of trial, but you've also got a table view, which is quite helpful if you're used to things like Notion databases, and also a hierarchy view as well, which might be helpful for being able to organize content that is hierarchically organized. You've also got a mind map as well, which is particularly helpful if you're trying to organize some notes for a project, or there's things that need to be done for a particular project, and you can start to create connections between the tasks as well. So over here with the plus button, you can go ahead and create a folder, a project, or you can add a task. And you can even import from Wunderlist and Microsoft To Do, as well as Asana as well. If you want, you can create what's called a smart view. So for example, if you wanted to see a global Kanban of all of your tasks across all of the different projects you're working on, which is particularly helpful for being able to narrow down what you need to do, then you can do that with task and Kanban view, as well as being able to see things like resource planning, reports, and reports as a sunburst, which is a very big sort of pie chart. And you can see that those reports can be particularly helpful for filtering down what exactly team members are working on and what they've done in the last week. Now, you've also got assignments, which means that you can see what other people have assigned you across all of the projects you work on, as well as a completed area and what you need to work on today and the week ahead. Now, there are some improved smart plans in here. So for example, you want to have more views, then you have to upgrade to their premium. And as I said here, if you want to go for the monthly plan, it's $9. And as you can see here, that gives you the monthly plus plans for the Zenkit projects. Now, one thing I didn't mention at the start is you can install this on all devices, including Linux. So for example, if you want to download it on mobile and also desktop, then you can do. And you can do all of the regular stuff that you would, like be able to change the background. In the plus plans, there are improved ways to set that up. You can also have sound on, sound off, and be able to change the authentication that you have, as well as some of the installed products you have in the area too. Now, this is particularly helpful when you're looking at adding all of the different other products that the Zenkit team have, like for example the base, and also Hypernotes and To Do and Zenkit Chat. Base is pretty much what this used to be, so obviously you'll be able to have that product there and bring that all up. But this is where you access all of your smart views and sort of everything that you've got inside of your plan. Now, this is a global calendar, so obviously you'll be able to see everything across all of the boards, but you can always come back to this page, which allows you to see all of your to-do projects and what status they're in, and also, you know, all of your tasks down this wing here. So Zenkit Projects is a pretty light-hearted project management application. It's definitely something that, for those who are project-centric that work in small teams, could be suitable for, but it doesn't have the level of design as the likes of ClickUp and Monday have. However, it does the job fairly well. If you're someone that already uses the Zenkit To Do application or any of their other products, you'll be used to the way that they design things. And I really like the way that they bring this dashboard into feature, as well as being able to use tasks to be able to filter down what you need to do for the day and the level of detail that you get inside of managing a specific task. One thing I really like is the ability to change between the variety of views like list, Kanban, calendar, Gantt, table, hierarchy, and mind map. Obviously, I think Gantt is part of the plus plan, or maybe if you want a secondary Gantt, it's part of the plus plan. But that's something that's quite rare. In a lot of applications, they tend to hide things like Gantt or table or even mind map under pro plans, but this is actually keeping it inside of the plans. Although you do get some limitations when it comes to the, you know, for example, tasks, projects, folders, and some of the storage, there are some obviously limitations, but it's definitely nice to have that from day one. I see a lot of people finding that very beneficial. So this application is a light project management app. It's easy to use and it can be used in a variety of different situations. I think that this is perfect for those who aren't necessarily sold on an application like Too Advanced, like ClickUp or Monday, and want something a bit more lighthearted to be able to manage their projects quite easily. And to be honest, I'm actually impressed with this application, but not like completely blown out of the water with its abilities, but I think it's a great medium ground project management software. So folks, hopefully you found this video useful. There's a full list of features that you can dive into and what's fully included. For example, they've got some great advanced filters, bulk actions, and also some more micro experiences that allow you sharing a little bit easier, like commenting and mentions, as well as a full Zapier integration, which might come in handy. So I'll include the link to them in the description below. But thank you very much, folks, for dropping by. Hopefully this review gave you all that you need to know about Zenkit projects. Thank you very much, guys. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very soon. Cheerio.